It's a mountain of poppies right there now. When those pesky bugs get into our homes, it's pretty tempting to reach for the spray can, but there can be much safer ways of dealing with them, and we're finding out with naturalist Martyn Robinson. Welcome to Studio 10. Great to see you. Now, not to be confused with a naturist.
No.
Yes. No, sans clothes. You are fully clothed. I want to ask you about spiders in a moment, but first let's get to cockroaches. Yeah. We've got some traps here that you're going to show us how
now,
to all use them.
They're just hiding in this corner. I thought they were just sort of doing something else, but they're all, why are they hiding in the corner?
Well, most of the cockroaches that you're likely to encounter around your home and garden, they don't like the light. Direct sunlight will actually kill them.
Oh.
So they try to hide whenever they're in an area where there's light.
Okay, and because there's light in the studio. There's one in the studio. So, but if we do that.
Well, that's probably going to disturb them a bit.
Yeah, no.
We'll get a few of them out.
Okay.
Don't take them out.
I'll just move that one back down again. But if you wanted to see these ones out, just.
There we go.
What are you doing next year for I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here? Let's talk about some traps that we can make. Because you're saying spraying poison isn't a great way to start.
Well, if it's poisonous to cockroach, it'll often be poisonous to us.
Sure.
Totally.
So, cockroaches. Okay. How do we get rid of cockroaches?
Well, you've probably got many of the ingredients to make a very effective trap yourself in your own home. Okay. One of perhaps the easiest is when you've finished your butter or margarine, leave it greasy.
Yeah.
And then just put in about a centimetre or two of cheap red wine. You can use the expensive wine if you want to, but they don't care.
Don't get any ideas down there.
Yeah.
Open it now?
Yeah,
you can do that.
So.
And then you put that in the cupboards where the cockroaches are, and the cockroaches will crawl in there to get to the wine. And they will drown in the liquid down the bottom. Ooh. And it's only when you get so many cockroaches in there that the bodies of the ones that have already drowned support the bodies of the ones that come in afterwards.
That's disgusting.
Is there anything besides red wine, white wine, vodka?
Anything we've got in the cabinet?
You can use apple cores, bits of fruitcake or whatever.
It's sweetness of the grapes, isn't it?
Yeah, well, it's just that way they end up dead, whereas with the apple cores and things, they're still alive.
Is it drowning or is it dying of alcohol poisoning?
Probably drowning.
Okay, all right.
But the thing is, you can then throw that out onto the garden and it doesn't matter if the chooks or the birds eat it. It's not going to poison
them. Good idea. Mm. All right, so what's next?
All right.
Well, this is another one and we could probably get...
Steph. All right, let's do it. Steph. What are we doing?
Right, so this is just a fruit juice container.
Yeah, the wasp, you're
the
a Catholic.
Top has been cut.
Body of Christ within
it. And you see there's a bit of a lip where it goes in like that. So get some Vaseline. And
this is for what?
This is for cockroaches
as well.
Okay. So we put some of this around the rim or something?
Around the inside, that's it, yep.
Okay.
And you just smear it all the way around so there's no gap that doesn't have Vaseline on it.
Okay.
Okay, so we need bulk Vaseline.
Yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Now what?
All right. Now you can also use cheap red wine if you wanted to. Yep. Or you can use an apple core or fruitcake. Just drop it in.
Yeah.
And then with there should be a piece of cardboard.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, that looks so it's a shorter piece of cardboard than the one we had originally had.
Something we've prepared earlier.
Yeah. Well, that one, that can go onto that side. This one, you could, excuse me.
Oh, is this?
Just.
It's like a ramp.
Yeah.
Got it.
Just put a strip of that up the side. And but not covering the Vaseline, so it's all on the outside.
Okay.
So right up to the lip.
Yep.
And then.
And what, onto the table?
No, you can just tear it off.
Okay.
Just so it's easier for them to climb up the plastic.
Yeah, so that's exactly it.
Okay.
So it's just made a super easy way for
careful with my trap here.
So they just crawl up there, get in there to there and cannot get out because they can't
get
past.
And that one's a bulk trap.
Mm, wow.
Get a little bit frightened at the number.
Big bang for your buck there.
Yeah.
Yep.
And once again, you take it out into the middle. Or the garden or probably as far away from your house as possible. Maybe onto one of the local... parks, grassy parks, tip it out and all the birds will come from
mosquitoes.
Yep.
Oh, disgusting. How do we get rid of mosquitoes?
Well, the easiest way to probably reduce the numbers would be to reduce the breeding places.
Okay.
So mosquitoes will always try to find a safe spot to breed, usually temporary water. Mm. So it'll be things like the saucer under your plant pots.
Oh.
It'll be a rain-filled tin can or bucket in the garden.
Mm.
I've seen a thriving amount in a wheelbarrow that people couldn't understand why they had hundreds of mosquitoes, but they didn't seem to be anywhere.
So what do we do?
Get rid of the water sources.
Get rid of the water, yeah.
Mm-hmm. I'm walking around my garden at the moment like this.
Mm.
Anyone who's seen me thinks I'm going absolutely mad.
Mm.
What are these spiders and will they kill me?
They won't kill you.
Mm-hmm.
They are actually doing a very good job with mosquitoes because
Great.
They have super sticky webs.
Yes,
if they're
they
the
do.
Ones that build the webs that are there during the night time you walk into that weren't there during the daytime.
These are golden orb spiders?
Garden orb
spiders.
Golden orbs, they're the ones that have the big grey bodies and the black legs with lots of yellow knees.
Yeah. Mm. So we just leave those, leave them alone?
You can leave them or you can do the same thing to both of those. What you do is if you've got your garden orb spider in the web,
mm-hmm.
you go up with a stick, you tap the web and it'll either run up to the right-hand side or the left-hand side.
Yeah. They don't like killing those spiders.
No. They're doing a good job.
Yeah.
And once it goes up into that corner, you regard that side of the web as the hinge. You go to the opposite side, you break it, and then it's like opening a gate. You swing it around and you attach it to vegetation.
How nice.
And then it won't build a web in exactly the same spot again. It'll use a new one.
Okay,
that you've chosen
so we've done cockroaches,
mosquitoes.
Okay, ants. Mm-hmm. I've got to say, I've got a lot of ants at various places around my house. So what do I do with the ants?
Well, if they're coming inside the house, it's a bit like the cockroaches. Mm. Part of their dependence on coming inside is looking for a water source. So they'll either come in if there's too much water outside.
It seems to be all about the water.
Yeah. They are actually outside.
Yeah.
So what do I do?
But what you do if they're coming inside, you find the spot where they're coming in and you use talcum powder.
Why talcum powder?
Well, ants
just around the corners of...
Well, where they're coming in. And what it is...
Is that too much?
That's way too much.
A little excessive.
But it would be very effective.
Okay, very effective. But you could maybe use that like that.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, what happens is you can see how fine it is.
Mm-hmm.
So as they walk across it, it sticks to their feet. They lick it off and it sort of sets in. It doesn't make them feel very good.
What about the other thing, if they're going up a wall?
Well, if they're going up a wall, they'll have to come down somewhere.
Okay.
So you can puffing it onto the wall, or you could find where the wall touches the floor.
Very quickly, we can't let you go without asking you, with all the kids going back to school, nits.
Yep.
What do we do with nits? How do we get rid of those?
Well, obviously there are chemical treatments, but if you're using it a lot, that's quite a lot of chemicals you're putting on your kids. So probably the old-fashioned louse comb is
that any product?
Just scraping that through their hair and removing the adults. And if you look at the kids' hair, you'll often find there's a tiny little white egg that'll be fairly close to the scalp, attached to a hair, glued to a hair. If you can't get that with the comb, just clip out that particular hair. And if you're diligent enough, you can control them mechanically.
And you're supposed to keep your children's hair as dirty as possible because nits love clean hair, don't they? They love laying the eggs in there.
Well, really?
All the chemicals that you naturally produce in your hair, we, for some strange reason, have got into the habit of washing them all out.
Mm.
And there's probably nit repellents in amongst them.
The grubbier, the better. It's been fascinating talking to you today. Martyn Robinson, everyone, with some great solutions.